Because worship is not something that we do for ourselves. It is something that we do for our God anyway. Right? It is not the opening number of the service.
Is people in worship opening lang naman yan?
No! This is called a worship service. It's not called,
ah, dito ba ng preaching service?
No. It's called worship service. The most important part of the service is the worship. Actually, after worship, you can go home. After offering time. Because again, that is an act of
worship.
Ayon, right? Because worship is what we do for God in gratitude of what He has done for me. Worship is something that we give to our God for, not only for what He has done or what He has given, but for who He is. Worship. Bonus na lang yung pagpalain ka, palakasin ka. Worship is something that we should do always for God. Worship should not be a time. Again, it should be a lifestyle. Lifestyle of worship. Everyone should be a worshiper. The second thing on how we can encourage ourselves is this. Get direction from God. Simple as it is. No complicated steps. After David sought the Lord in worship, the latter part of those verses in 1 Samuel chapter 30, he called for the ephod, or the vest, and inquired of the prophet, what shall they do? They inquired of the Lord, and they said, shall we attack them now or not? Is this the time for us to attack them and take back our wives and take back our family? Then the Lord said, go, run after them, you will overcome. You will get them back. Get direction from God. Sometimes when challenges happen in our lives, we have our own preconceived things on what we should do, right? Diba? Meron na tayong iniisip, ah, ganito, ganito. Then the next step, the next thing that you would do is you would ask people for their opinion, suggestion, or perspective. But all the while, you have already your preconceived plan and you're just asking for people to confirm it rather than really seek advice. Amen. Diba? Amen na right? Meron ka rin eh.
Alam ko na gagawin ko. Ay, magsisik muna ako ng advice. Pero yung isisik mong advice, after lumahanap ka rin, papampi sa'yo. Kalaban ko yan, hindi tama yung sinabi. Hindi tama yung sinabi base sa gusto mo. Ano? Ano ba ang gusto ng Diyos? What would Jesus do? WWDJ. What would Dean do? What would Jesus do? Like that. You ask yourself, as a Christian, not on my own merit, not to protect my integrity, not to protect who I am personally, but would God be glorified? What would Jesus do? Get your direction not from what you want, but from God wants. And you can only hear from God after you worship. Because now you're clearing your channel. Hello? You're clearing the channel and your connection to God. Now you can hear from God. Sometimes when something happens to us, we are full of anger, hatred, and all those negative things, clouded na yung ating mga judgment. But when we begin to worship, align our spirit to God, now the channel is clear. We can hear from God clearly what He wants to do in this situation. Then, you will hear it from God. Be sure to obey. Because it's always the best. Not from what you want. Not from what other people want. Not from majority of them want. But what's the right thing to do? What's a biblical thing to do?
So David inquired of the Lord.
Pero sometimes I say it's hard to read Bibles when you're in the middle of a problem, di ba? Right? It's hard to pray when you are in the middle of a situation. It's not whether we want it, it's whether we should do it. And we should do it. The more we should read the Bible, the more we should pray, the more we should go to church.
Pastor, I'm taking rest from the church because I have problem now. But it does not.
Parang mas nabi daw. Tsaka na kita pupunta sa'yo. May sakit pa ako ngayon eh. Doesn't make sense, right? Hello? Huh? Doesn't make sense. You go to the doctor when you're sick. You go to the church as a hospital so you can be healed. So you can be touched, you can be... No one's perfect here.
It's when we go together corporately worshiping God, that we're being touched by God and being blessed. Then we have a clear direction from the Lord.
Diba?
Amen. Amen.
Last but not the least, number three. Now, three. How can I connect this? Okay. Treat others fairly. How can you incorporate that to encouraging yourself? Now, if you read that passage in 1 Samuel chapter 30, this is what happened. So God said, okay, pursue them, you will win. Pursue them, you will get back all your families. Okay. Now, David has 600 men. Remember, they just had, they were just in a battle. So out of the 600, 200 of them says, David, we're too tired, we cannot go with you this time. You can read it, 1 Samuel chapter 30. So only 400 went together with David. The 200 were left. Naiwan yung 200. Pagod na pagod eh. Siguro wounded pa yung iba or something. So only 400 went with David. They chased the Amalekites. They won over them in victory. They took everything, their wives and their sons and all their possessions. They even have their spoils of war. It means, meron pa silang mga blessing na nakuha sa mga Amalekites. When they got back, naturally, the spoils would be divided to who? Normally.
400.
To the 400, right? It's fair. Because they were the ones who attacked. They worked for it. Sabi nga nila. But if you read the passage there in 1 Samuel chapter 30, David said, divide the spoils to the 600, not only to the 400. Huh? Now, I don't fully understand that, but that became a law during the reign of David. Okay? The 200 were left because they were so tired, but still they received some of the spoils that the 400 of them fought for. David said, no, let's be fair. Give the 200 to them. Because it's not that they don't want to fight, it's just that they cannot fight because of physical fatigue. Yan yung sinasabing, the spirit is willing, their flesh is weak. Parang ako minsan, when I go to the Philippines 7 days, I like to do everything. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is 45 years old.
25.
I like that. The tithes will be 5%. Not 10, 11%. It's just that they're just so tired. So David, want to be fair to everyone, treat everyone fairly. Okay, divide it even to the 600. Right? Let's go beyond what is normal. Let's go to what is generous.
let's go to what is sometimes not fair to everyone, but it will make God happier. Okay, I was fellowshipping with a Cooper, and he told me something. He said, you know, Pastor, being in this church for a long time, I have catched the spirit of blessing others. Sabi niya, let me make confession to you, Pastor, and my wife doesn't even know about it. Now the wife will know about it. No, it's not your husband. I hope I'm not in trouble. But the husband said, you know, Pastor, I've been supporting someone in the Philippines.
Oh.
26-year-old with cancer. You don't have anything. Out of my allowance, I'm giving them money. Just so this family of the wife being 26 years old, suffering from stage 4 breast cancer, can move on. The kids being small. I don't even know them that much personally, but I just got introduced by a third party. Nobody knows, but you being my pastor, I want to say this to you. I said, I've been doing that for quite some time. So I said, wow, that's very normal. Right? Yeah. Pwede mo namang hindi gawin yun? You can just pray. Because sometimes the most visible act, expression of your prayer is when you do something that you can do. Right? It's one thing to, okay, I'll just pray for you. It's another thing just extending your arm physically or just being physically there to help and not only pray. Right? In Facebook, when I enumerated the things that we need in our new building, so let us, we need, how much? I totaled it at $16,000. I can understand that not all of you liked it, although you have read it, because I saw that you saw it. Seen by 96, liked by 18. I see you there. 'Cause I know you. Then one family came to me and said, Pastor, I'm giving this money. We're giving this money and prayers. Now, I didn't write that to burden you, actually. And I was telling a hoper yesterday that actually our church is loaded. Our church can pay for that. Right now. Right here. With a check. Boom, 16,000. We can. Our church is not poor.
Amen.
Because the hopers are not poor. But I did that so I can incorporate all of you to have the sense of ownership for that new building.
Amen.
Of course I can write the check for 16,000. Pay all of that. Yes, we can. Remember, we've been renting this place dirt cheap. Because of that, really dirt cheap. But we, and because of that, we have saved a lot of money. Although we are spending thousands of money in the Philippines. Remember, the more we give, the more we've been blessed.
Yes.
Right? If we have, hindi natin binigay yung thousands of dollars to the missions, we could have even bought that place, this new building. But we know, we would rather invest in people rather than in building.
Yes. Yes.
Yet. Yet. Because I believe God will bless us with the building.
Amen.
So, you like nyo naman. Scene 96, flight 18. So Pastor Noli encouraged himself in the Lord. Yung
iba nga, hindi mo lang tinapos yung basa. Hindi na tinignan.
No, I'm just kidding.
So, I just did that so we can have a sense of ownership. We desire prayer skills, and we need that. But I want us all, being a part of this family, to have a sense of accountability and ownership for it. How much is a chair? $30? Wow, one of those chairs is mine. I put my name behind it. I reserved that for me. The last time we bought our chairs was the folding, this one. Last time we bought that was 7 years ago? Mary? 8 years ago? Let us continue to cultivate this family, generous. Let's continue to cultivate that this is mine. I'll do something about it. Treating others fairly, exercising benevolence. And some even you will think, well, we were faithful in our tithes, so why aren't our tithes faithful? Yes, we do. And we will do part of it, because I don't expect to raise 16,000 just to have a simple offering, no. No, actually, the AC costs somewhere, Patrick will know, 8,000 to 10,000, but we will install it, but the owner will refund us on a monthly basis because the AC that's being installed there will be his anyway. Hindi naman atin yun. Hindi naman pagkalis natin dun eh. Tanggalin ang aircon. Ando na yun. As we believe that as we elevate to high school, graduate ka ng elementary. Okay? Valedictorian ka. So we're joining the big boys. Hallelujah. Are you excited? I am excited. It's a miracle. If God has given us that place, God will give us everything that we need to be in that place. Not only chairs, not only projectors, not only that, God will entrust us with future hopers that will make hope for the world their home, their church, their family. Amen? We pray that in Jesus' name. That's why God gave us a bigger space. Not so you can run around, no. Just so we can fill it with potential hopers. Or just waiting to be invited and discover the most beautiful church in this part of Los Angeles. And what is that church?
Hope for the world.
Hope for the world.
Saved by 96, led by 8.
Praise God. Naging 96 bigla. Nagpe-Facebook sila.
A new place, they will be moving to another newer, bigger place. Hallelujah. It's exciting time.
Let's keep ourselves serving the Lord. Today, our JIL Book 1 chapter has just celebrated their second Sunday. Amen. Sa bahay pa lang ng pastor. We like humble beginnings.
Amen.
Huh? I like what Manny told our pastor in Butuan City. Well, it's good that you started in the living room. When we start our church, we started it in the bathroom. Pastor June, the Samsons, the backyard of the Samsons. 13 years ago. Yung speaker, kailangan mo sipahin para ano. Hindi yung speaker, yung speaker. Now, there are 5 tribal mountain churches who wants to affiliate with us. Yay! Number 1. Resources. Pastor Noli encouraged himself. Hallelujah. Yeah? We don't know where it will come, but we know to whom it will come from. Hindi natin alam saan manggagaling, alam natin kung kanino manggagaling.
Amen.
Now for that 8,000 that we need para sa new building, I don't know where it will come from. I know where it will come from. From your checkbooks. Now from God.
Amen.
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 Amen. I'm excited. So, magtiis po tayo dito hanggang June. And some are already collapsing. There's no, isa na lang restroom natin. Tinalo natin ng target. Transgender na agad yung ating dalawa. Yung men or women. Huh? Everyone included. But hey, we thank God for this place, right?
Amen.
It's not the place that makes the place holy. It's the people gathering in the place that makes the place holy. Because after the backyard of the Samsons, we moved to a Bisco Hall. Now, Hope Heart for the World in El Paso, they're meeting in a disco hall too. With that
mirror board.
This, it looks globe, so Heart for the World, it's a globe. Oh, we're so glad. Now we can invite people to go to the church. There will be no parking issues. We're starting a ministry. Ang dami mga nagsuggest. Pero what I like so far is yung sinuggest ni Patrick na kinek. Key. Part ng connecting yan. Kinek. Kinek. Yung mga Uber driver dyan, yung mga balay driver dyan, kayo yung... Angelo, Jesse. It's just 3 houses away to a parking lot that can accommodate up to 60 cars. I counted our, on a given Sunday, the number of cars that we have is about 33, 34. So we have enough parking space. And it is Sunday. Let us encourage ourselves in the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let's bow our heads and let us pray. Oh God, we thank you. Right now, I pray that God would encourage you. I don't know what you're going through, brother. I don't know what you're going through, sister. But right now, the presence of God is here. This may be your first time. You may be new here. You may be an old timer here. But you're undergoing something. You're going through something. And you're weak. And sometimes you're frustrated. You don't know what to do. You have hit the rock bottom. Your face.